In a previous lesson, you have learned how the prismatic compass is used for taking magnetic bearings and for finding direction on the ground. There are many situations on active service to which this use of the compass may be applied. For instance, here is the leading section of a strong fighting patrol operating in featureless jungle country, which we represent by this woodland. The patrol is going forward to reconnoiter the line of a river running across their front, about 3/4 of a mile ahead of them. And owing to the nature of the country and the thick undergrowth, they will have to keep changing direction on the way. The film will show this operation as an exercise in the use of the compass, not as patrol instruction. The patrol is prepared to fight for information and can call for artillery support through its wireless equipment. It is necessary, therefore, that it should be able to supply the gunners with a map reference for any target observed, and to do this, the patrol must keep track of its own movement. The starting point is known to the gunners. The patrol leader is not carrying a map in case he falls into enemy hands. He is going to keep direction by compass, and has detailed one man to keep a record of their changes of direction and the distances travelled on each leg of the patrol. Here you see them setting out on the first leg of their journey, the bearing of which has already been noted. And here you see them changing direction at a sharp bend. You must imagine this as a jungle track with impenetrable undergrowth on each side. At this point, the patrol leader takes a fresh bearing, whilst the man makes a note of the distance they have travelled on the last straight stretch. At this point, the river appears in view on their left front and far below. They must now make their way down to its level by a devious route, and at the same time make an accurate record of their movements. On the previous leg is again noted, and the fresh compass bearing is taken. And in due course, they arrive at the river. So far, no enemy have been encountered, but gunfire has been heard and enemy shells have passed overhead. The patrol leader observes from the cover of the undergrowth and sees flashes of gunfire from the opposite bank lower down the river. He takes the compass bearing of the gun position 17 degrees and estimates its distance from his own position 700 yards. His problem is now how to get this information back to the gunners as quickly as possible and in such a form that they will be able to deal with the enemy. He plots his compass bearings and distances on a piece of paper with his protractor, making a diagram of his route. They started off on a bearing of 85 degrees, and the distance travelled on that bearing was 240 yards. He uses any convenient scale on the protractor to express the distance. Using each primary division on the top scale to represent 100 yards, he marks off the distance representing 240 yards. 40, 140, 240 yards. The bearing of the second leg was 46 degrees. distance traveled, 320 yards. Third leg, 128 degrees. Distance, 260 yards. Fourth leg, 88 degrees. Distance, 330 yards. That brought them to the river bank. Finally, he draws his line of observation across the river. Distance, 700 yards on the observed bearing of 17 degrees. This marks the position of the enemy gun. Now he draws a line connecting his starting point to the gun position and measures this bearing with his protractor. It is 57.5 degrees. He next measures the distance along this line using the same scale that he used for plotting the other distances, 1430 yards. Now he must convert this compass bearing of 57.5 degrees into a magnetic bearing. He knows that his compass has an error of 1 degree east of magnetic north. The magnetic bearing of the enemy gun position is therefore 58.5 degrees. And he sends a message back to the gunner. Range on enemy gun position from patrol starting point, distance 1430 yards, magnetic bearing 58.5 degrees. And after a short interval, here are the ranging shots. This is an example of a counter battery shoot worked out by compass bearing, with the patrol leader acting as forward observation officer. By keeping a record of his bearings and the distances traveled on each bearing, he was able to work out the position of the enemy battery without the aid of a map. Here's another example of the use of the compass in action. This platoon commander, from his forward position, spots the flash of an enemy mortar. He takes the bearing of its position, 20.5 degrees. Compass is correct. The platoon commander, you will call him A, passes a message through company headquarters to battalion headquarters. Enemy mortar position, 20.5 degrees magnetic from 278639. This message goes to the battalion intelligence officer. Enemy mortar position, 20.5 degrees magnetic from 278639. The first thing he must do is to convert this magnetic bearing to a grid bearing. From the bottom margin of the map, he sees that the magnetic variation in 1942 was 10 degrees west of grid north, annual decrease 10 minutes. Assuming that it is now 4 years later, the variation to the nearest half degree is 9.5 degrees. So he converts the magnetic bearing to a grid bearing by subtracting 9.5 degrees. Grid bearing, 11 degrees. Now, with his protractor, he plots grid bearing 11 degrees on the map from map reference 278639. The enemy mortar position must be at some point along this line. Another platoon commander, whom we will call B, also spots the flash from the same mortar and takes a bearing on it, 110.5 degrees from position B. His compass has an error of 1 degree west of magnetic north. So he sends a message back. Enemy mortar position, 109.5 degrees magnetic from 261651. This message also goes back to the battalion intelligence officer. The magnetic bearing of 109.5 degrees is converted to a grid bearing of 100 by subtracting 9.5 degrees as before. This second grid bearing is plotted on the map from map reference 261651. The enemy mortar position must be somewhere along this line. So it must be at the point of intersection of the two grid bearing lines. Map reference 279648. This procedure, the taking of bearings from two known positions, in order to find the position of a third, unknown point, is called intersection. The nearer the two bearings from the known positions make to a right angle, the more accurate will be the position of the third point plotted. For instance, here are bearings taken from two known points, A and B. They intersect, making a right angle, at point C. Now suppose that we allow a possible error of 1 degree west and east in the bearing taken or plotted from point A, and a similar possible error from point B. Point C may now lie anywhere within this small lozenge-shaped piece of ground. Now suppose the two bearings are taken and plotted from two points, A and B, closer to each other. In this case, the angle formed at the point of intersection is 30 degrees. And you can see that the size of the lozenge is increased, giving a much larger area of possible error on the ground for the same possible error of 1 degree east or west made in the bearing. If the error in the bearings is increased to a possible 2 degrees east and west, you see that a very much larger possibility of error on the ground is produced. If the angle between the bearings is increased to a right angle once more, the area of error is still considerable, but it is materially less than it was with the bearings making an angle of 30 degrees. So remember, the nearer the bearings make to a right angle, the more accurate is the position of the intersection plotted by them. The greater the variation from a right angle, the greater is the possibility of error on the ground. Finally, here is an NCO who wants to report his exact position to HQ. He knows that the hill feature on his left is Yar Tor, and that the one on his right is Higher White. On the map, Yar Tor on the right, Higher White on the left. He takes a bearing with his compass on the top of Higher White, ...274 degrees. And on the top of Yar Tor, 174 degrees. Now he must convert these magnetic bearings to grid bearings. He must first find out from his map what the magnetic variation is from grid north. He makes it 9.5 degrees west of grid north. He works out his conversion by means of a diagram, taking into account the error of his compass, 1 degree west of magnetic north. And finds from his diagram that the compass bearing of 274 degrees becomes a grid bearing of 263.5 degrees. and the compass bearing 174 becomes a grid bearing of 163.5 degrees. Now, 263.5 degrees is the grid bearing of higher white from his position. So to plot his position on the map, he requires the back bearing, that is, the bearing of his position from higher white. The back bearing will be 263.5 degrees less 180, equaling 83.5 degrees. So from higher white with his protractor, he plots the bearing 83.5 degrees. He now knows that his position is somewhere along this line. Now he takes the grid bearing of 163.5 degrees to yard tall and converts it in the same way into the back bearing. 163.5 plus 180 equaling 343.5 degrees. So from yard tall with his protractor, he plots grid bearing 343.5 degrees. His present position must also be at some point along this line. So it can only be at the point of intersection of the two grid bearing lines. Map reference 083001. To save working out the back bearings, the NCO could, with his protractor, plot on the map the forward bearing of 263.5 degrees away from higher white on the far side, and then produce the line backwards towards his own position. Dealing similarly with the forward bearing drawn away from yard tall. The point of intersection of the lines produced backwards being again at map reference 083001. This process of fixing a position from two previously identified positions without visiting them is known as resection. Once again, the nearer to a right angle the bearings make at their point of intersection, the more accurate the result will be. So remember these additional uses of the compass. To keep track of your position relative to your starting point. From two known positions, the plotting of a third position without visiting it, called intersection. And resection, the plotting of an unknown point from two known positions without visiting them.